The sanctified life, self-righteousness condemned. Our Savior ever condemned self-righteousness. He taught his disciples that the highest type of religion is that which manifests itself in a quiet, unobtrusive manner. He cautioned them to perform their deeds of charity quietly, not for display, not to be praised or honored of men, but for the glory of God, expecting their reward hereafter. If they should perform good deeds to be lauded by men, no reward would be given them by their Father in heaven. The followers of Christ were instructed not to pray for the purpose of being heard of men. But thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father which is in secret, and thy Father which seeth in secret shall reward thee openly. Matthew 6, verse 6. Such expressions as this from the lips of Christ show that he did not regard with approval that kind of piety so prevalent among the Pharisees. His teachings upon the Mount show that deeds of benevolence assume a noble form, and acts of religious worship shed a most precious fragrance when performed in an unpretending manner, in penitence and humility. The pure motive sanctifies the act. True sanctification is an entire conformity to the will of God. Rebellious thoughts and feelings are overcome, and the voice of Jesus awakens a new life which pervades the entire being. Those who are truly sanctified will not set up their own opinion as the standard of right and wrong. They are not bigoted or self-righteousness, but they are jealous of self, ever fearing lest, a promise being left them, they should come short of complying with the conditions upon which the promises are based. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 1. True and False Theories Contrasted.